Hello and a warm welcome to MedHead, your medical study guide in Europe. So we are making videos to encourage you and to guide you for all possible options in Europe where you can study medicine. What are the degree options? What are the possible universities? What is the cost of accommodation and so on? So today we have Mr. Peter with us, who is the CEO of MedHead. Thank you, Mr. Peter, for joining us.
Thank you very much.
And he will be walking us through a very special university, the University of Ostrava, which is offering medical studies in the Czech Republic. So, or Czech. Yeah, now how it is called.
Yeah. Both ways are legal, I suppose.
I guess, yeah. So we'll be walking through it. So, Mr. Peter, give us some insight about the University of Ostrava, Czech Republic in general, and the city of Ostrava.
Yes, University of Ostrava is offering many was so far it was offering mostly the study programs in Czech language, but this is like very fresh news.
Okay, I
also got it just yesterday that from the academic year 23-24 they will also open the English program of the general medicine.
Wow.
And Ostrava, it's big industrial city.
Yep.
It's located in Silesia, close to Polish borders. It's a place where from this year the university will welcome the first batch of the
medical students.
Yes,
that is great actually. Mr. Peter, thanks for giving this insight. By the way, Czech Republic is a Central European country, so you're very well connected by land to all the neighboring countries, including like Germany. If you want to go take a short flight, take a train, everything. So if you're completing the degree over there, you want to move, you want to travel, it's a great place to be in.
Mm-hmm.
What about the tuition? Like, how much does it cost? Because our viewers would generally like to know how much the entire tuition cost.
Yes, tuition fees are 11,000 euros for 1 year, 2 semesters. We did one video, previous video was about the studying medicine in Czech Republic as such.
The link is here.
So we mentioned that the cheapest was at Palecki University, it was 12,500 euros, but with Ostrava University now the price comes down. So now the cheapest option in the Czech Republic is Ostrava, it's 11,000 euros.
Wow, that's actually pretty great. And what about the admission process? How many, first of all, like seats are available? Because people will be competing for those seats, you know. What is the admission process? Like, do you have to give any entrance test and so on?
Yes, the minimum number of the students for the university to open the program is 15, and the maximum is 50. 50.
Okay, so you have to be in the top 50 to get in.
Yes, so well, yes.
Yeah.
You need to pass the entrance exam, which consists of 30 questions from the biology, 30 from chemistry, and 30 from the physics. Totally, you can get 90 points, and in order to qualify, you need to get at least 10 points from each section.
Okay.
But your total mark should be at least 45 points.
All right. So you need to probably brush up your physics, chemistry, biology skills. And I expect if you're coming for medical studies, so probably you have in your high school already PCB combination, and you just need to like give this entrance test. By the way, is this exam like available online or is it offline? Like,
it's online exam, and you can log in. You do not need to travel there in person.
That's great. What about the application fee?
Yes, the application fee is 2,000 Czech crowns.
Okay.
Approximately, let's say you can tell it's 80 euros.
80 euros, right.
And most probably the most of the students will be from the Germany, Greece and UK. That's my estimation.
Okay. So it's very good because you will get a lot of international friends over there from different countries. And what's the tenure of studies? How many ECTS or European credits?
Yes, so it's the same as in different universities in the Czech Republic. So you study for 6 years. Okay. You need to get 360 credits.
Right.
And your degree is recognized, so you can then work in any country of the EU.
All right. So this is a very good thing because you get an affordable degree, you stay in an affordable country, so, and then you're open to the world entirely, and especially European Union to be specific. So if you are coming from third country, or even if you are coming from European Union, it's a great affordable place compared to many Western European universities, because the Western European universities are really expensive in those terms. But here you get the same degree with much affordable options. Speaking of affordability, Mr. Peter, what's generally like the accommodation and, you know, living expenses for a month in Ostrava?
Yes, as Ostrava, it's not that big or that expensive city. Like, you can start your minimum budget from €400, but we can tell that maybe in the times of inflation, maybe this number might go up. And also, let's keep 400 as a minimum. But also, you will not face that big issues, let's say, finding accommodation compared to other megacities in Czech Republic, like Prague or Brno.
Yeah.
I would say like 500, 600 should be okay. As a budget.
That's quite affordable, I would say, because considering like Prague, or actually these major cities are really expensive, and it's hard to still there, like, you know, manage your accommodation, manage your entire study tenure, the pricing, affordability, everything. So Ostrava is like much affordable option, and it's like pretty open, pretty nice. It's like easy to travel from there to Prague, to Berlin, anywhere where you want. Mr. Peter, like, you know, many students are like quite intelligent, want to study more, and, you know, want to explore more options and so on. So is there a place for like scholarship or something like this to make it even more affordable for students like this?
Yes, University of Ostrava also offers quite generous scholarship compared to other universities. Like, they specifically mentioned that the scholarship maximum can go up to €3,600, which is very unique.
Generous, yeah.
It comes for the students with the best marks, so for the excellent students, apart from the students that are in the first year. So anyone else can apply.
So it means like if you're like from second year, third year, so probably the best case is if you try to keep your marks as high as possible throughout the 6 years of studies, then you will get this like affordable, like, you know, this financial coverage and the scholarship.
Yes.
Yeah. So that is a good thing, because for students who are like willing to work hard for getting a scholarship, for getting like better marks, it's really good. What about the practical exposure, hands-on research and all these, you know, because that's like super interesting for most of the medical students. So what about that? Is there a scope for these sort of things?
Yes. The university has strong collaboration with the local hospital. So it's called Ostrava University Hospital.
Okay.
Then they have even a new simulation center. They call it training hospital, where you can come and you can like get hands-on knowledge. Then you can also be involved in the faculty research. But what is really interesting is that you can even for their summer internship, let's say, you can go for the non-profit programs in Africa.
Wow.
And you can then help people in local hospitals or clinics.
It's like a super international exposure, I would say. You come to Europe, go to Africa for your internship. That's amazing.
Yes, universities, they don't mention this, because usually this is done by the study organizations like IFMSA and others. But this university is mentioning this exclusively. And finally, I would say it's also the living costs and the tuition fees are quite affordable, so it can be a really interesting place. It's close to international airports in Poland.
Okay.
Like, there is big airport in Katowice and Krakow.
Yes.
So this could be also one option to get to this city and university.
That is actually pretty nice. You have good international connections, and also, you know, you are in Czech Republic, so very, very central position throughout Europe. Easy to travel, come to Slovakia, go to Germany, go to Italy, anywhere, like, you know, it's like sort of a center position, so that's pretty nice. Mr. Peter, like, in the first place, why should someone consider Czech Republic, Ostrava, you know, to study? Like, what's the, you know, the unique point about it? Like?
Well, if we speak about Czech Republic, they are very high in the quality of life, and also like the in the rankings of the safety. Like Czech Republic yeah. is really safe country, and they have established these medical programs and English study programs yeah. for the international students, and then they keep contact with the alumni students.
That is very important.
To track their progress and to maybe get feedback what they can improve. Studying in Ostrava can be like unique experience because they restart this program from this year. Okay. So if you do not, for example, are fan of big overcrowded cities with millions of tourists such as Prague, and you wish to get like unique experience where the teachers has a lot of time for you, mm-hmm. Because there are maybe 1 to 2 study groups.
Oh wow!
Maximum 3, so you can get like really personal contact with your professors. Then Ostrava can be the right choice for you.
This is like very important because, you know, with the big universities, it's like you're just a number. No one even knows your name. Yeah, but with like if you go to the universities in the smaller cities, it's very nice because you have this personal touch, personal connection, and from your professors you will even get like so many internships, so much knowledge, so many international connections. So it's very important to do that. So Mr. Peter, like anything else you would like to add about the university's program and offering for our viewers? Well, and also mm-hmm. do mention the general timeline. When should a student start this entire process for application?
Yes, the application process itself, it's not difficult. Like you need to submit the application online. Okay. You have deadline until end of June, and for year 2023 to entrance exam will be on 19th of July.
Okay.
But as it was mentioned, the entrance exam will be online. As we mentioned also in other videos, if you want to multiply your chance of getting admitted, like yeah. apart from big universities, you can also add like some, you can keep this Ostrava, let's say, as backup option.
Plan.
If you are not like 100% sure whether this could be the right place, you can also consult with the study office, international office at the university yeah. that can also give you more information, and definitely you can also check the description below the video where you can find also details about the University of Ostrava and studying in Czech Republic as such
in general. So that is great. Thank you, Mr. Peter, for giving all this insight. And if you like the video, do give it a thumbs up, by the way. Thank you for watching. And the most important thing is, you know, when you have the option to go for an affordable option for the same degree, I would suggest to go for that because then you have exposure and also your budget saved to explore the rest of the world, the rest of the opportunities, than spending like really a ton of money on just getting the same degree just because of you know, like you're getting to like a particular school or a particular country or a particular city. So that is in general. Do share the video with someone who's planning to study medicine, who is planning to move to Europe, or even based in Europe exploring the different medical study options. Everything will be linked in the description, all the important points that we covered and the documents. And the most important thing is we are going to have a common email in the description for Mr. Peter. So do reach out to him. So if you're planning to study in Europe, medicine, or exploring different options, do reach out to him. Ask him over email, like what are the possible options based on your profile, based on the, you know, your financial condition, your affordability, everything. Do take a consultation from him. That's my personal suggestion. Get idea. Jot down and write like 5 universities or 3 universities that you want to target, and then accordingly proceed for those. So for this entire, you know, paperwork, application, everything, Mr. Peter is here to guide you, help you with that. So do use it. That's my personal suggestion, and thank you so much again for watching the video. Do subscribe to our channel. Until next time, see you. Bye bye.
Bye bye.